And he has a diagram which has these pieces in it. It's somewhat similar to yours, and it differentiates between subroutine calls, which are indicated here by the lines with the arrowheads, with the big arrowheads, and accesses to the memory, which are lines with the smaller arrowheads. And he also breaks out system I/O, that is the reading of the input and the writing of the output. So that's solution number one. Take a minute now and see if you can come up with another solution.
Okay, so for my second solution, I've tried to decentralize some of this because it sounded like the system was just too heavy. So the system is still comprised of these components for parsing, something to circle what we've parsed, and sort and then display. So I have the parser, the circler, the sorter, and the displayer, but I'm trying to treat it as if it's like a running through a process in which the system doesn't have to negotiate everything. So we start
a step at a time?
A step at a time.
Okay.
So we start with the parser. The parser does its job, passes its output to the circler. The circler then creates all of our different, you know, shifted versions of the lines. That gets passed to the sorter. And then the sorter sorts it alphabetically and passes that on to the displayer.
Okay. This sounds very similar to what Parnas calls the pipe and filter solution to things. So let's take a minute and look at that.